Coach Kim here, excited to give you 10 minutes of abs of steel. Now you hear me say it a lot, abs start in the kitchen, so I know you're working on that part, but the second part to that is we need to tighten them up, firm them, and we need to be consistent with it. So let's get ready for abs of steel, 10 minutes, here we come. We're gonna start with the weakest part of our abs, at least for most of us, and that is your lower stomach. So that movie popcorn, you know, those chocolate covered pretzels and raisins, they all tend to go in our lower abs. So we're gonna be working on that right now. So I'm gonna have you on your back on a nice firm surface. So if you have a yoga mat, a towel, I'd like you to lay on your back with your knees bent. And I'm gonna show people options on how to make things harder or easier. So you do what works for you. Your abs are gonna love this. Your head's gonna be relaxed. I want your hands by your side with your palms facing down. You're gonna lift up both those legs. I want you to hold them up, hold, and then go down nice and slow. Good, now keeping the knees bent, this works great for people with back issues. So you're gonna come up, hold, push down with the hands, and come down slow, perfect. The name of this exercise is called a reverse crunch. Up, and again, the target is the lower stomach, and down, and we're gonna keep working. Now, if your back even hurts you doing the two legs together, you can always just do one knee at a time, but we're doing some abs of steel here, so if you can, let's do both legs together. Beautiful. Up, and I'm also gonna show you a little bit of a harder variation. For those of you, if your back is 110% healthy, you have no issues, up, and you don't have any back pain, what you can do is extend the legs out straight, then pull the knees in. Oh, I know I felt that. So bringing it out and bringing it in. Now that's only if your lower back does not bother you. Otherwise, let's keep those knees bent. I'd like to get a couple more. Lift up and hold. And are you breathing? Make sure you're not holding your breath. Some people naturally, just breathe. Nope, I want you to breathe down. So breathe out during the exertion phase. So as you bring the knees up, breathe, hold, come down slow. We're gonna get one more. Lift up, and down slow, good. Now just a quick little stretch, dropping the knees to the side. Again, that lower back, it's always nice to segue into a back stretch when you do ab exercises. Just a quick little knee drop. Your lower back loves you for this because I am prepping you for our next exercise. Perfect. I'd like you to put your one foot on top of the other. I'm using my left leg. I'm gonna support my head. What I don't want you to do is tuck the chin. So pretend you got that tennis ball under the chin. My right elbow is going towards my left knee. So I'm gonna crunch up, support my neck, and come back down. Now the advantage of this one, we're working a little bit of the obliques, the sides, and your upper abs. Breathe out as you crunch up. Excellent. And look at the ceiling. So look at the ceiling above you. Lift and lower. You're gonna feel this in your tummy. Excellent. And we all wanna have a nice flat tummy, don't we? Yes. And you know what? Those of you that are getting to know me, and you hear me repeat this a lot, repetition is that key to learning, is do you know the abs first start in the kitchen, all the way up. So it's important we tone it up, but you're not gonna get that skinny abs by just working out your abs, okay? So you need to be focusing on your diet, eating like you live on that island. So focus on your portion control and your choices. Okay, switch sides. So put your other foot on top, hands behind, breathe out, crunch up. And I want you to come up as high as you can, see if you can see me here, to feel that contraction in the abs and back down. So what I don't wanna see is this, okay? You're gonna have a neck ache with that. So breathe out, crunch up, and then come back down. Good. I don't know about you all, but are you feeling this in the abs? Yes, I'm sure you are. Breathe out and up. Keep going. Let's get a couple more. Up. Yes, abs do start in the kitchen. So you start doing this. Oh, and you could do this every other day. Let's get one more. Up and back down. But if you seriously write down everything you eat and drink, you know, download the app MyFitnessPal and start staying within your budget of calories and making better food choices. Just watch what happens. Really good stuff. All right, next one we're gonna do is go back to that reverse crunch. So hands by your side, you're gonna lift up. I'm doing a second set here and down. I'm gonna let sometimes I hold my head up just because I'm watching you out of habit, come back down, but your head is nice and relaxed. So those of you with neck issues, this is a good choice for you. And come back down, good. You know what I like to do, and you're gonna laugh at me when I share this with you, my family just ignores me because I've been doing it so long, but when the commercial comes on TV, so you're watching a TV show, commercial comes on, you know what you can do? Hold on to the back of the couch and do this exercise. You can get those hips up even a little higher. And so just do, I don't know, why not do 20, 30 crunches, reverse crunches during that commercial? You know what I'm saying? I know, you guys think I'm nuts like my family, but that's okay. All the way up. I'm used to people thinking I'm nuts. Let's get a couple more. Up, up, up. Down. One more. Up. Hold, hold, hold. Think abs, think abs, think abs. And drop. Hug the knee. Actually, hug the knees to chest. Again, I like to stretch the lower back anytime we do some ab work. So now we're going to go back to the one where we did originally. Put one foot over on top of the other. My left leg is my left foot sitting on my right knee. I'm going to crunch up and come back down. Again, my eyes are to the ceiling. Breathe out up, supporting my neck, not pulling my neck. So are you doing this? Haha, we need to fix that. Chin off the chest, eyes up, breathe. And let me tell you, I'm going to share this with you because there's a lot of truth to this. When you think about the muscle you're working, do you know you work that much more? So if you're thinking about your abs right now and the kind of abs you want and how you're feeling them contract, you will work it more than if you're thinking about, oh, I've got to do this for Johnny and I've got to go to the dry cleaners. I've got to make this for dinner. You know what? We're thinking about our abs. Up and down slow. Let's switch up. Go to the other side. Put your foot on top. Chin off the chest. Breathe out. Crunch up and back down. Abs, we don't call this abs of steel for nothing. I know you're feeling it. I'm feeling it. All the way up. Breathe. I want you to breathe as you come up and come back down. But I promise you, if you all download that free app that MyFitnessPal I speak about, and there's another one called Lose It on your phones, and use it. Don't just download it, but use it. Document everything you eat and drink. Make better choices in combination with what you're doing right here. You're going to see some nice changes with that belly. Up, up, up. Just try it for a week. See what you think. And up, and then come back down. Let's hug those knees to chest again. Hug, hug, hug. Now, we didn't call this abs of steel for nothing, did we? I want those feet up at tabletop. So we're gonna do a good old fashioned exercise called a bicycle crunch, and I want you to crunch. Now, those of you that might have a mini band, I don't know if you know what a mini band is. It's a little round bands, elastic. You can put those around the bottom of your feet. It makes it even harder. I'm just putting it out there. Up and crunch. Excellent. Eyes to the ceiling. Drop that leg. Now remember, I'm supporting my neck. If you feel it in your neck, we need to revisit how you're holding your neck. Reach out. Oh, those abs are burning for me. How about you? You're getting mad at me now, aren't you? Good. I'm glad. That's okay. You'll get over it. And reach. Good. Elbow. Opposite knee. Give me another one. Up. Up. One more for fun. And lie flat. Hug the knees to chest. Good. As a matter of fact, connect those fingers on top. Hug them in because we're getting ready for a second set of bicycle crunches. Yes, they've been around a long, long time. I remember my mom in the 70s doing these. And she also used to have a rolling pin and she'd do this. And I don't know why she was doing that. She thought that would get rid of her stomach. But up, up, up. I still laugh to the day of this memory. Reach. So getting the rolling pin out and rolling your stomach won't do anything. Okay? Just trust me there. I think I gave you a good laugh. Reach, opposite elbow, opposite knee. Very nice. Now, if you're feeling some back pain, let me show you an option to this. Notice how my legs are bent, okay? So if you have any kind of back pain, bend the knees, okay? This is a nice option, and that's support. So this would be the harder version. A nice little easier version is going to be with the knees bent. How the abs doing over there? Yes, do you have a six pack yet? I'm just kidding. Reach. Keep going. We're just going to stay right here till we get a six pack. Let's get a couple more. One more. Up and drop. Let your head relax. Pull those knees into chest. Hug the knees. Hug them, hug them, hug them. Guess what we're going to do? Yes, we're going to do it again. We're going to do this one. Hands by your side. Lift up, reverse crunch, and then bring it down. Again, those of you with healthy back, extend the legs out straight. Okay, not a healthy back. You keep the knees bent. Okay, they're both great. Lift up. So we're gonna do another round of each exercise, which means you'll have completed three rounds of the reverse crunch, the legs over the knee crunch, followed by the bicycle crunch. Good. Up. Down. One more. Up. One foot on top of the other. Lift. Good. We're just doing a nice ab workout. Abs of steel. It's really important you're breathing. Are you breathing? Don't hold your breath. Let's get another one. Good. I'm not giving you much rest. That's okay. You'll have plenty of time to rest after this. Whoo! And then I can't wait to see you again. Keep going. And again, you could do this every other day or go by the soreness factor. You can do it every day, but if your stomach is sore or any muscle for that matter, it does need to rest. Hold the feet up, crunch, crunch. So I'm targeting all of your abs, upper, sides, lower, good. You've got three more in you. That's 3, 2, and 1. Thank you for joining me on your abs of steel. Do they feel a little firmer? And yes, remember those abs start in the kitchen, so just promise me you're gonna be mindful about getting more fruits and vegetables in your diet. Remember to always check with a physician before starting an exercise program.